We have four anniversaries today, three of which are from the illegal abortion days. Who do you think performed them? Doctors, nurses, midwives, the neighbor, a sister, the woman herself? Listen and you'll find out. This is Christina with the Sisyphean Journal, and today is December 14th. Our first death today was from December 14, 1911. A 34-year-old mother of four named Ella died at German-American Hospital in Chicago. Ella, who was a homemaker, named Dr. Robert H. Forster as her abortionist. He was held by the coroner's jury and indicted on December 19th, but I'm unable to determine if the case ever went to trial. Like, share, subscribe. Get me monetized so I can go to Chicago and learn about these women's deaths. The next one is from 1916. A 19-year-old clerical worker named Eleanor died at Columbus Hospital in Chicago from septic peritonitis by a criminal abortion. She also named a doctor, Maurice Perlstein, as her abortionist in a deathbed statement. Two other people were held to the grand jury and Perlstein was charged with murder. Again, like, share, subscribe. I want to go and read the source documents and find out what happened. Now we move ahead to 1918 and geographically move to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Walter Huffnagel of Pittsburgh noticed on Wednesday, December 14th, that his wife, 19-year-old Emma, was sick with body aches. By Saturday the 7th, Emma's mother was told of Emma's illness and went to visit her. Emma told her mother that since her period was about 2 weeks late, she thought she was pregnant and had used a catheter on herself on November 30th. On December 9th, the family agreed to have Emma moved over to her mother's house, but Emma didn't do any better under her mother's care. So they brought her to Presbyterian Hospital, where in spite of the doctor's best efforts, Emma died of peritonitis and septicemia at around 2:15 a.m. on December 14th. Now we're going to move ahead to the safe and legal era. I don't know much about the death of 36-year-old Edith. All I know is that she submitted to a safe and legal abortion in New York. On December 14th of 1991, she was unresponsive and taken to the hospital emergency room where staff were unable to save her life. Her death was listed on her death certificate as pulmonary amniotic embolism after an induced abortion.